Shalom everybody, it's Tazra again, coming back at you with yet another video exposing the dishonesty and straight up deception coming from people on the other side, Abu and faithful to God once again. If you thought the last video was good, just wait until you see this one. This video is going to be a follow up from the last one, but this one is going to be straight to the point because I've noticed that the longer and more detailed these videos are, the more room these liars have to deflect and move the goalpost with loopholes and technicalities. There's no need to spend 4 or 5 hours babbling in videos like Faithful does when the facts are so simple and easy to deal with, so let's get right to it. And this is a quick disclaimer. In a recent response video that aired on December 20th, Faithful made a sneaky attempt to reinforce or repackage his position on the topic of the Black Portuguese Jews by going off into a lot of other things to deflect and try making up for the fact that Abu admit the Black Portuguese Jews were literal black people who had literal black skin complexions that resembled black Africans. Northern Ethiopians or Eritreans specifically, and we can see that right here. This is the screenshot where Abu admits that. So any new points Faithful tried to make in his recent video are going to be completely ignored and disregarded during this video because it's too late. He already had a chance to make his argument and it obviously didn't work out the way he thought it would. If he truly believed he had a solid argument, then there wouldn't be any need for him to spend an additional 4 to 5 hours trying to bandage himself up in order to stop the bleeding. And this is another quick disclaimer. I'm going to be using the word mulatto a lot during this presentation, but I want everyone to know I don't have anything personal against mixed race people. I'm just going to be using that word to address points and arguments made by Faithful in a proper historical context because this is a word that was used multiple times in one of his videos. So please just bear with me and I hope it doesn't offend anyone. So, now that it's been brought to Faithful's attention that Abu admit the sources he's been shown about the Black Portuguese Jews were talking about them being black literally, he and Faithful are trying to play games and save face by claiming Faithful acknowledged and showcased images of actual black Jews and that Abu hasn't contradicted Faithful's position. But in reality, Faithful has only acknowledged or showcased images of mulattoes, or black Jewish people who had Caucasian ancestry on their father's side. All of a sudden, ever since the last video I did about Abu, Faithful is claiming that he has been misrepresented and is now emphatically promoting the idea that the word black has a wide range of usages and that that's what he's actually meant all along. And I'm going to play a clip of him saying that himself in a few minutes. But if that's what he truly believed and what he has been truly arguing all along, then why does he and why has he had a problem with Israelites saying the black Portuguese Jews were literally black? Does that make any sense at all? Or does it just sound like his deception and dishonesty has finally started to catch up with him? Now I want everybody to pay very close attention to this screenshot I'm showing right now. This is Abu, something he said to me, I believe it was either a day or two after the last video aired. You can just ignore this part up here because he's trying to deflect from what I'm asking him by bringing up the Lankados when I've made my position on the Lankados very clear in the previous video and one prior a few months ago. But you can see right here he says to me, we, you and I, talking about me and him, we seem to agree that the two 19th century sources you had me examine were referring to Portuguese Jews who were quite dark-skinned. I spoke with Faithful about the Calcutta Review, and I'm going to pull that source up in just a little bit, and he agreed with me that the source is referring to dark-skinned Portuguese Jews. So, if Faithful is now agreeing that the black Portuguese Jews were black or dark-skinned, then why in the past has he tried to counter Israelite sources speaking about black Portuguese Jews by claiming that the Portuguese Jews were white or Caucasian men who had mixed mulatto children with dark-skinned black women in Africa? How do black or dark-skinned men have mixed or mulatto children with black or dark-skinned women? It takes a white person and a black person to make a mixed mulatto child. Two dark-skinned people cannot make a mixed mulatto baby. So obviously the white Portuguese Jewish men who were capable of making mixed mulatto children with black women were not the same people as the dark-skinned black Portuguese Jews. Faithful has now basically admit that there were two different groups of Portuguese Jews being spoken of in these historical sources, and he is too caught up in his web of lies and anti-black hatred to even realize it. And just in case Faithful tries to turn around and play games about what he meant by dark-skinned, here's another screenshot of Abu clarifying exactly how dark Faithful admits the black Portuguese Jews were. Here we can see he says, Faithful agrees that the 1846 Calcutta Review, which I'm going to bring up in a few minutes, is referring to Portuguese Jews who had dark skin, like the Cochin Jews, like many Indians. The question is, why should we think that contradicts his earlier stated positions? I don't think it does, and neither does he. We're gonna deal with this later, okay? But according to Abu, Faithful agrees the black Portuguese Jews were as dark as Indians. Now, the source in question actually used the phrase black as Negroes, but of course Abu and Faithful are going to ignore that and use Indians as a reference, but that's okay. Because even if the black Portuguese Jews were as dark as Indians, they still would not be able to create mixed mulatto children with black women in Africa. So still, either way, whether he realizes it or not, Faithful has basically admit that there are two different groups of Portuguese Jews being spoken of in these historical sources. So not only has Abu debunked Faithful, but Faithful has now also debunked himself. I'm sure we all remember Faithful trying to argue that the black Portuguese Jews couldn't possibly be dark-skinned or black simply because there are books talking about how white Caucasian Jewish men went to Africa from Portugal and had mulatto children with black African women. Well, now he has a huge problem because his positions are beginning to contradict each other. What a surprise. It's to the point where we don't even need to use sources on these guys anymore. I could technically end the video right here. So before I go, I want to give a few shoutouts. First to Dante. Thank you for letting me do these presentations on your channel. Second, I want to thank all of the Israelites who are standing strong in the faith and truth. And last but not least, I want to give a big thank you to Abu and Faithful to God for helping further this truth with their recent admissions. All praises to the Most High. I'm just playing around. Let's keep going. Before moving on, another important question we need to ask ourselves is, if Faithful now admits these black Portuguese Jews were dark-skinned, and if we know the black Portuguese Jews were banished and sent to West Africa as slaves, then where did all of these dark-skinned black Portuguese Jews go, and where are they now? And why hasn't Faithful ever talked about them before? Now I want to quickly go over just a few comments from Facebook that show what Abu and Faithful are trying to say, now that we've gotten Abu to admit the black Portuguese Jews were actual black people. We can see here, this is a post from the day after the last video aired by Tim Cole Conley. Forgive me if I'm pronouncing your name wrong, but he says, Abu, what have you got to say for yourself? You a cherry picker? Abu responds and says, greetings, Timco. Thanks for thinking of me, and I extend similar thanks to Dante and Tazra. I haven't finished the video yet, but we'll do so soon, and then share my thoughts. Then he goes on to say, in the meantime, would you be willing to share what in the video stood out for you personally? I see this and I say to Abu, no, Abu, thank you for accidentally exposing Faithful to God's lies and severely flawed argument concerning the black Portuguese Jews. He lied and claimed no sources about the black Portuguese Jews were talking about literal black people and argued on multiple occasions that black Jews were either converts or had Caucasian ancestry. Common sense and honesty says otherwise. Now we're going to see how deceptive Abu tries to get as the conversation goes on. Greetings, Tazra. I hope you are doing well. As you might have anticipated, I don't see it the way you do. I'll type up and share my thoughts on a number of points raised where I feel clarification is needed or is at least helpful. For now, I'll share that I honestly feel you have not shown any contradiction between my position on the relevant 19th century sources and any position taken by Faithful. With all due respect, you merely set my positions in opposition to, at best, an oversimplification of Faithful's position. And then he goes on, but right here at the bottom, he says, that said, I wanted to comment on this portion of your post. Faithful lied and claimed no sources about the black Portuguese Jews were talking about literal black people and argued on multiple occasions that black Jews were either converts or had Caucasian ancestry. That sentence seems to contradict itself. Are you saying his position is that neither a black convert nor a matrilineal descendant of black persons can ever be a literal black person? I look forward to your thoughts. And you can see here, he drew up on my comment and marked the parts that he felt contradicted each other. I have it blown up right here. Abu claims that the part in red and the part in green contradict each other. He lied and claimed no sources about black Portuguese Jews were talking about literal black people. He believes this part contradicts the part that says he argued on multiple occasions that black Jews were either converts or had Caucasian ancestry, when they don't contradict each other at all. He's once again trying to save face and deflect from the fact that he debunked Faithful. Let's go back here and see what I say to him. You can continue to play dumb all you want. Nothing I said contradicts anything else I said. And I repeat what I said. I said those two points do not contradict each other. He said the sources were not talking about literal black people, and then he argued that the only black Jews were descendants of Caucasian Jewish men or converts. Okay, so those two points don't contradict one another. Abu knows full well when Israelites say black or the Jews were black, we're not talking about mulattoes. Then Abu responds, you seem to have changed the wording a bit. Recall that you have been saying Faithful's position was that no sources were referring to literal black people. I didn't say that either. All I said was that Faithful claimed the black Portuguese Jews weren't literally black, and that's what he was trying to push. Okay, I didn't say no sources were referring to literal black people. In every case where the mentioning of black Portuguese Jews is cited, Faithful to God claims that we are misreading the sources and that these black Portuguese Jews were actually dark complexioned Caucasian people. Or pretty much anyone but black people.
His argument about the semantic ranges of words like dark, black, etc. apply to all the sources. No, not all the sources. That's not what I said. Okay, and I was very clear about that. And then he goes on to say, well, that begs some questions. Are the relevant alleged converts you refer to not literal black people? Can a person with lots of West African admixture, but a paternal line that recently connects to a non-black man still be a literal black person? Well, I'm sure we all know the answer to this, Abu, but that's not the point I'm trying to make. Because we aren't talking about mixed people when we talk about black Jews. And when the sources that you read said that the Jews were black, they weren't talking about mixed people. So he's deflecting very hard right here, okay? And he's trying to make it seem like just because Faithful showed images of people who had black ancestry but a white father, that he hasn't contradicted Abu. But that's a straw man argument, okay? And I say everything was explained in great detail in the video, so we're pretty much going in circles at this point. So I start tagging other people so that I can have witnesses, and then we're going to see what they say. Abu says, Tazra, let's try to go through this carefully. Were any of the alleged converts or descendants of intermixing literal black people? Yes or no? He's asking me if mulattoes were considered black people. Technically, yes, they are. But the point is, the sources that Abu was shown and admit were talking about literal black people were not sources that were talking about the black Portuguese Jews being mulattoes. So this is a major straw man argument. And as you can see right here, I say yes, but that's irrelevant because as I've stated multiple times, Faithful argued that the only black Jews to exist were those who were converts or had a Caucasian ancestry, which as you have affirmed is not true because the sources you have been shown about black Portuguese Jews were talking about literal black people who did not have Caucasian ancestry and were not converts. So here, he's still deflecting. He's still saying the same thing over again. And me and him are just going back and forth. And then we have, at this point, Pacrocino, forgive me if I'm saying your name wrong, but he comes and gives some input. Let's see what he says. Faithful to God's point was that the Portuguese Jews of Africa mentioned in the articles were originally of a presumed European Jew origin, as if only by virtue of a European Jew, a black Portuguese Jew was authentically a Jew. The suggestion undermines the notion of black as being, or at least in part, what defined Portuguese Jew. I believe inherent in Tazra's and Dante's case is that the Portuguese Jews are originally black and Jew by patrilineal descent. But Faithful to God makes the case that what makes these black Portuguese Jews authentically Jew is their genetic ties to European Jews who fathered children in Africa. Faithful to God even attempts to use one of the sources to support his case. So he gets it. He sees what Abu's doing and he breaks it down in a different way. Abu still tries to play games after this. Abu says, the point of my questioning of Tazra is that he originally claimed Faithful's point about the semantic ranges of relevant terms applied to all sources under discussion. When I said he did not apply that to all sources, I was accused of lying. So I'm merely trying to clarify an issue I was accused of lying on. Then our good friend Saya Harris jumps in and he gives some input. Let's see what he says. I believe Tazra is speaking to bloodline black Jews, Abu, not Jews in a national sense. So his statement isn't contradictory. I believe in this statement, Tazra is stating that the Portuguese Jews started out with a very dark hue, and saying they had European ancestry is a straw man argument. Abu, I think you know what the brother is stating. Let's not muddy the water with technicalities. And Pacrocino replies one more time, and he says, well, Abu, we know what Faithful to God argued, and it's clear from his lives and the proofs taken from them. If you've made a defense that wasn't consistent with Faithful to God's position, then you may have misfired. But at this point, it's relevant, because we can all see what Abu's doing. And here's one last set of comments I want to show. I made a post. Let's see what Abu's saying here. We were going back and forth, and he was still playing games, like how in the previous slide I showed. So I tried to come at him in a different way, and I say, Abu, I just thought of a good question to ask you. In your opinion, why didn't Faithful to God show any examples of people with literal black skin complexions in any of his videos concerning what he believed the black Portuguese Jews looked like? Abu says, I'm not sure he showed nothing, but of course some of that which he affirmed he won't have photographs of. For example, he cannot be expected to have photos of 17th century Senegambian Lankados. Nonetheless, while I'm not very familiar with the videos, browsing it now, it seems he may have come close in some regard. So he's saying, no, he didn't, but he may have came close. For example, the Joseph Nassi picture, admittedly who was of Spanish rather than Portuguese descent. So he shows this picture here. This guy is a mulatto. We're going to get into that later. And then he shows another image. Then there was the Fernandez family in Suriname. These people are mulattoes too. We're going to get into that in a little bit, okay? Just remember these two pictures. When I asked him if Faithful showed any black people, these are the two images he showed. And we're going to get into them in just a little bit. And we're going to ignore this part because you can see right here he says, and while I know this isn't what you asked about, on a related side note, so he's trying to go off topic here. We're going to ignore that, okay? Because it obviously doesn't have anything to do with what I'm asking him. So keep in mind, when I ask Abu why hasn't Faithful shown any black people in his videos, actual black people, Abu comes back in response with photos of mulattoes from Faithful's videos. So now, the question is, why are mulattoes being referred to as a defense for Faithful's position on these black Portuguese Jews when none of the sources I showed Abu said that these black Portuguese Jews were mulattoes? If Abu has not contradicted or debunked Faithful as he claims, then he should be able to easily provide an example of Faithful showcasing examples of black Jews who were not mulattoes with skin tones similar to the black Africans that Abu admits the black Portuguese Jews would have looked like. But he can't do that because he and Faithful are not on the same page, and he has in fact debunked and contradicted Faithful's position. Yet Abu continues to lie and try to cover up for Faithful by pushing these images of mulattoes as some sort of loophole or technicality when he knows full well that none of the sources I showed him were talking about the black Portuguese Jews being mulattoes. This is called a logical fallacy. And here we have the definition of a fallacy pulled up. A fallacy is the use of an invalid or otherwise faulty reasoning or wrong moves in the construction of an argument. A fallacious argument may be deceptive by appearing to be better than it really is. Some fallacies are committed intentionally to manipulate or persuade by deception, while others are committed unintentionally due to carelessness or ignorance. The soundness of legal arguments depends on the context in which the arguments are made. So we can see that Abu and Faithful are trying to lead us to a false conclusion. And the false conclusion that Abu and Faithful are trying to lead us to in this case is that Faithful did mention or acknowledge black Jews, therefore Abu has not contradicted Faithful's position. But in reality, the only black Jews shown by Faithful were mulattoes with Caucasian ancestry. By doing this, Abu and Faithful are both being intentionally dishonest yet again, because by only showing mulattoes or black Jews who had Caucasian ancestry as a reference, Faithful is still being deceptive and ultimately still pushing the same false white supremacist narrative that the black Portuguese Jews were not already black to begin with. What else should we expect, though? His silly argument has been dismantled, so the only way for him to keep his dead and dishonest argument alive is to keep being dishonest and fueling it with more deception. Now everybody, just imagine what would happen if Israelites started showing photos of mixed people who had black fathers and white mothers. For example, Mariah Carey, the Ball Brothers, Halle Berry, or Blake Griffin. Imagine if we started presenting images of biracial people with black fathers and white mothers as a way to get around the historical sources that talk about Jews being white. And imagine if we said, hey look, these mixed people with black fathers are the white Jews being spoken of in these sources. People on the other side like Faithful would laugh at us and make attack videos about how we're false teachers trying to be deceptive. Yet Faithful for some reason thinks he can get away with this BS. At this point, it's really his only hope because Abu has told the truth about the sources and admit they were talking about literal black people who resembled black Africans. So now Faithful has to pretend that he showed images that support what Abu said, when in reality, he only showed mulattoes. The sources that Abu admit were talking about the black Portuguese Jews being literally black were not talking about mulattoes. In regards to the black Portuguese Jews, Faithful did not show a single image of any black Jews who were not mulattoes or the descendants of Caucasian people in his attack videos, and I made this point very clear in the last video I presented on Dante's channel on December 14th because I knew it would come down to this and that Faithful would try to weasel his way out of this mess by taking things in that direction so that he could have something to fall back on.
So what is Abu talking about? What's he talking about? I have noted that their argument about how words can be used and have been used did not apply to all sources, nor did it constitute a denial of the existence of dark-skinned Jews, as they themselves acknowledge the existence of dark-skinned Jews. Now here, what Abu is saying is that he's trying to make it seem like I'm misrepresenting Faithful. He's saying Faithful acknowledged dark-skinned Jews. I don't know what Taz was talking about, but Abu is being deceptive, because as we all remember, the only black or dark-skinned Jews that Faithful was acknowledging was the Jews, or black Jews, that he said were the descendants of Caucasian Jewish men who intermarried with African women, or converts. Faithful never said anything about a source talking about actual black Jews who were just black Jews by blood, without being the descendants of Caucasian men or converts. Okay? So Abu, he's being deceptive. Because Faithful never read a source about the black Portuguese Jews being black, said, yes, this is talking about actual black people. He never said that. Okay, so bringing this up is irrelevant. That's a red herring. That's a straw man. Whatever you want to call it.
I wasn't able to watch all of Faithful's most recent 4 to 5 hour long video because I have a life, but from what I did see, Faithful and Abu somehow missed that very important part, or they purposely chose not to acknowledge or address that point because they knew it would expose the deception and dishonesty they are using to try and keep Faithful's argument on life support. In his recent video, Faithful also complained and tried to make it seem like I misrepresented him because I only used one or two images from the original video he made.
Using Caucasian as a morphological reference, lineage reference, something else. So for example, you know, it's silly to think that what our friend Abu was saying here somehow contradicts what we've said, because we show dark-skinned Jews and various other dark-skinned people in our presentation to show the dynamic range of terms like Swarthy, while also showing people like Walt Whitman who were referred to as Swarthy, because that was the ultimate end goal. Can we go to the next slide, please? Here's some more. This is basically Abu just pointing out where he says, again, Tazara, stating that there are instances where words like black, dark, swarthy can and have been used to refer to persons many 21st century Americans would consider light-skinned, does not mean all usages of those words are referring to such. I seriously doubt 93 or Faithful ever claimed otherwise, nor have you shown that they claimed otherwise. But more importantly, you presented my interpretation of specifically the source at the start of the thread as contradicting their use of a picture of Walt Whitman. So I'll explain. So Tazra used something from the Calcutta Review where particular Jews were referred to as black. And he takes that as basically any instance of Portuguese must theoretically always be in reference to black Jews. And he thinks that when we say, look, when we look at these old sources, the Portuguese Jews are referred to as sometimes black, sometimes white, sometimes etc. It's not the case that we think that the Portuguese Jews morphologically all resembled Walt Whitman. However, it is the case that you had people with Walt Whitman's, who was not a Jew, by the way, with Walt Whitman's phenotype. You can find that phenotype amongst the very Jews that Tazara wants to claim as his own people. And at the same time, you can also find people who morphologically fit Tazara's position of black, of what he assumes the term black entails. So in our presentation, we mentioned black Jews. We referred to black Jews. We showed instances of where literal Jews were black, for example, the Lanzados and various other groups that were clearly morphologically black. And yet he seemingly ignored all of that just to arm a straw man argument based on Walt Whitman and not even considering why Walt Whitman was used in the first place.
Now, in reality, in every image he showed during that video, all of the people he was making a case for had pretty much the exact same skin complexion as the person in the images that I did show. Therefore, it would make no sense and would be a waste of time for me to have shown all of his examples since they all look the same. We also heard Faithful mention the Lancados, which were a group of Jews who were banished from Portugal during the Inquisition. Faithful says he believed the Lancados were black, but what he isn't telling you is that his own personal opinion is that they were the descendants of white men, even though I've already shown a historical source from 1621 in the last video that says the majority of the Lancados were as black as the natural inhabitants of Guinea, which is in West Africa, and that they were already black. So once again, Faithful is being deceptive as usual. Now let's take a quick look at all of the people Faithful showed during the video in question, and let's see if he really showed any black Jews like how he claimed, or if he was just picking images of a specific type of black people in order to push a false narrative. As you can see, I've stripped every single image of examples that Faithful posted in the video in question, and we're going to go through all of them. And you can see the name of the video here, when it was streamed, and you can also see the timestamps for each photo that we're going to go through. Keep in mind, these photos aren't in order. I just took them as I found them. So we can see, we all remember, It was being argued use of black, darker, swarthy for non-black individuals. Now let's go through the photos and see who or what type of people were being shown. This is the image Faithful's complaining about. He's saying, by only showing this image, that I'm misrepresenting him. Let's see if he showed any images of people that looked the way Abu says the black Portuguese Jews would have looked, or any black people in general. But keep in mind, Abu said that according to the source, they would have had skin tones similar to Ethiopians or Eritreans. We remember this image as well. Now, these guys aren't black, okay? You can see it says dark Negroid features, okay? Meaning they aren't black. They just supposedly have black features. So, three pictures in, no images of black people. Let's keep going. Does that look like a black Jew? Does that look like an Ethiopian or an Eritrean? These are Syrians. Are they black? Do they look like Ethiopians or Eritreans? These are Yemenite Jews. Are they black? Are these black Jews? Is this a black Jew? This guy is not black because right here you can see it says lipstick often Negroid-like. Negroid-like, meaning he's not black. Is this a black Jew? Is this guy a black Jew? I'm not sure. I could be wrong, but I think this guy might be a mulatto. He might be a mulatto, but I'm not sure. Anyways, either way, he's not black, and he's not a black Jew. Never mind. I don't know how this got in here. This must have gotten here on accident. These are actual Ethiopian people, okay? These people look like what Abu said the black Portuguese Jews would have looked like, according to the source he read. Anyways, this isn't from Faithful's video, so let's keep going. Does this look like a black Jew? Is this a black Jew? Is this a black Jew? Do they look like Ethiopians or Eritreans? Does this guy look like Ethiopians or Eritreans? Is he a black Jew? What about her? Is she a black Jew? Does she look Ethiopian or Eritrean or have a skin tone similar to what they have? Is that a black Jew? Does he have a skin tone similar to Ethiopians or Eritreans? What about her? Him? Says dark skin. Is that what Ethiopians or Eritreans look like? Their skin complexion? Is this a black Jew? Is she a black Jew? Where are the black Jews at? Faithful said he showed black Jews in his photos in this video. What about them? Does that look like black Jews? Do these look like skin complexions that Ethiopians or Eritreans have? What about them? Now here's the photo that we looked at earlier that I said Abu sent me and I told you to keep in mind. Joseph Nassi. I asked Abu, why didn't Faithful show any pictures of black people? And he referred me to this. But if you look this guy up, Joseph Nassi, he's a mulatto. It says he's Afro-Jewish. He had Caucasian ancestry on his father's side and his mother was black. The sources I showed Abu were not talking about the black Portuguese Jews being mulattoes. So why is Abu showing mulatto pictures? Why is he referring me to mulatto pictures from Faithful's videos? Why is Faithful claiming he showed black Jews when he's really just showed mulattoes? This is the second picture that Abu referred me to. And you can see it says, you're an African Jewish family, white father, mulatto, mother Surinamese. So why is Abu pointing me to photos of mulattoes? Because he knows Faithful didn't show any pictures of what he claims to have showed, and all he has to show are these people. This is as close to black that Faithful got, and these people aren't even black. They're mulattoes. The sources I showed Abu were not talking about mulattoes. Faithful and Abu both act like Faithful's videos aren't still up for everyone to see, and that we can't simply go back and scroll through them to see exactly what he was arguing. But more importantly, I did not build a case on just that one image alone, and in the last video I presented on Dante's channel, I also made it very clear that according to Abu's admission about the black Portuguese Jews having literal black skin complexions like black Africans, none of the people being shown in Faithful's videos looked the way Abu admit the black Portuguese Jews would have looked like. And when I said that, I wasn't referring to just one or two pictures from Faithful's video, I was clearly referring to all of them.
So that's enough with this particular post. One of the main takeaways from this is that Abu has just admitted that this source that I just pulled up and shared with him is not talking about dark complexion Caucasian people. He listed African groups of people, so-called sub-Saharan African groups of people, Northern Ethiopians or Eritreans. Those are Africans, and they're literally black. literal black people. You can look up Ethiopians or Eritreans on your own. We all know what they look like. They don't look like none of the people that Faithful was showing in his videos. And Abu just admit that. Not directly. He didn't say, hey, you're right. But that's what he's saying here. He gave an example. And the people he listed do not look like the people Faithful is showing in his videos.
So Faithful lied and built a straw man argument to attack. Faithful also told another blatant lie about my position on the topic and falsely accused me of believing all Portuguese Jews were black when I never claimed that at all.
So I'll explain. So Tazra used something from the Calcutta Review where particular Jews were referred to as black. And he takes that as basically any instance of Portuguese must theoretically always be in reference to black Jews.
Whenever I'm talking about the black Portuguese Jews, I always literally refer to them as the black Portuguese Jews, and for this exact reason, to avoid any confusion. My position has always been that the black Portuguese Jews were black, not all of the Portuguese Jews. Only a dummy would claim that all of the Portuguese Jews were black. Everyone in the world knows there are white or Caucasian people who identify as Jewish. Faithful lies so much that he doesn't even realize when he's lying. I've made my position on this topic very clear as well, back on August 10th, during the first presentation I ever did on Dante's channel.
During the Inquisition, the point I'm making is that there's two completely separate groups of people who call themselves Jews, okay? I'm not denying the existence of white or Caucasian Jewish people who identify as Jewish, nor am I denying the fact that there are historical sources that speak about white or Caucasian Jewish people. The point being made here is that there are two completely different groups of people. Those who began to identify as Jewish at a certain time period in history versus those who are actual blood descendants of Abraham.
Falsely accusing me of claiming or believing that all of the Portuguese Jews were black was yet another misrepresentation and strawman argument constructed by Faithful to God. So where did Faithful get this false representation of my position from? You want to know where he got it from? He made it up and ran with it so he could have an escape route to dig himself out of the hole he's put himself in with his lies. I've never said anything like what he accused me of saying, nor can he provide any evidence of me saying that. Look at the amount of blatant lies and extreme misrepresentations that were told by Faithful in just a matter of minutes. Yet he confidently accuses myself and our community in general of doing exactly what he spends most of his time doing. It's the same thing he and the racist Christians always do, whether it be with history, the Bible, or anything else they try using to push their false narrative. They lie and misrepresent, and then accuse us of doing it. The clip I played of Faithful talking is from the 11-minute mark of his recent video, so that means he started the video off with lies. It's safe to assume the rest of his video is full of lies and misrepresentations of information as well. Faithful, you are a liar. Stop trying to teach people. Stop trying to correct people. Stop trying to vet sources. Stop making debunking and exposing videos. You only debunk and expose yourself. You are one of the biggest liars on the internet. I can't speak for Dante, but this is the exact reason why I myself had no interest in debating you back in the summer. I knew that instead of it being an actual debate, it would just be me correcting your lies and trying to get you to represent my position properly. You are a blatant liar. Now, back to Abu and the importance of the recent admissions he has made when I showed him these sources about the black Portuguese Jews. The two sources in question here are talking about the black Portuguese Jews themselves being black, not their descendants, and the sources in question are not talking about their blackness being the result of intermarriage between black and white people. Nor are these sources talking about these black Portuguese Jews being converts. This is yet another key point that I was sure to make clear and emphasize in the last video I presented on Dante's channel on December 14th, but Abu and Faithful repeatedly ignore these key points because it's the only way their dishonesty can have a chance at survival.
As you all heard, Kevin mentions Abu's name as he tries to push this narrative about the Portuguese Jews not being actual dark-skinned or black people, but as it's been clearly established in this video, Abu has stated multiple times that the sources I've shown him about the Jews of Portugal being black were talking about literal black people with literal black skin complexions, not any dark Caucasian or European people, and especially not any people who resemble the ones shown in Faithful's video. I'd also like to clarify that none of the sources I showed Abu were talking about the descendants of Portuguese Jews being black. They were talking about the Portuguese Jews being black themselves. And Abu agreed.
I'd also like to clarify that none of the sources I showed Abu were talking about the descendants of Portuguese Jews being black. They were talking about the Portuguese Jews being black themselves. And Abu agreed.
So with that being said, why is it that Abu and Faithful keep presenting mulatto people as examples even after I pointed out in my most recent video that these sources were not referring to mulattoes? The answer is because they are scrambling to find a way to draw attention away from the fact that Abu has completely contradicted Faithful by admitting these black Portuguese Jews were literally black. Instead of showing images of mulattoes or black people who were the descendants of Caucasian Jewish men who intermarried with black women, Faithful needs to deal with the fact that these sources are speaking about the black Portuguese Jews being black themselves. A literal blackness, like what can be witnessed in black African populations, like northern Ethiopians or Eritreans, according to Abu. When I showed Abu the first source, he admitted the fact that he was saying the black Portuguese Jews would have had skin complexions like northern Ethiopians or Eritreans, which are black sub-Saharan Africans. This is him admitting it right here. Let's take a look at the source. I'm sure we remember from the last video, if you've seen it, Sources of History in the Pentateuch. Six lectures delivered in the Princeton Theological Seminary by Samuel Colcord Bartlett. And we're on page 118. It says, thus, the black color is found not only in individuals as the black Jews of Portugal, but in tribes as the Bakaris on the Red Sea, whose hair and character are perfectly Semitic. Where does it say they were mulattoes? It doesn't say that. Where does it say they were the descendants of white people who married black people? It doesn't say that. So why does Abu keep referring me to photos of mulattoes? And when I showed him the second source, Abu admit that according to the source, the black Portuguese Jews were darker than the skin complexions shown of the people in Faithful's video. Here's that screenshot of him admitting it here. And here is the source in question, the Calcutta Review, Volume 5, page 289. Scroll down to here. It says, some of the Brahmins of high caste are black. Many Arabs of pure blood in the middle of Africa are as black as Negroes. The Jews of Portugal and of Cochin are very black, though they do not intermarry with natives. It clearly says they do not intermarry with natives. So why is he showing mulattoes in reference to this source as well? And the funny part is, when Faithful tried to explain this source away in his video, he had everything highlighted except the part where it says black as Negroes. He only had the part highlighted that said the Jews of Portugal and of Cochin are very black, because he was trying to still play that game and make it seem like black isn't saying what it says it clearly is right here. Black as Negroes. But anyways, when he first saw these sources and admit they were talking about black people, literally, Abu didn't say anything about them being mulattoes, and that's because the sources did not say they were mulattoes. And as I've already shown, all of the people shown in Faithful's video had a similar or the exact same skin complexion, so by default, Abu has actually admit that the black Portuguese Jews were darker than all of the people shown in Faithful's video. And on top of that, Faithful didn't show any examples of any people who had skin complexions similar to northern Ethiopians or Eritreans, like how Abu admit the black Portuguese Jews would have had. At the end of the day, Faithful is trying to play games by referencing black people who were mulattoes with Caucasian ancestry and showcasing their black phenotypical characteristics, but anyone can see he's trying to be deceptive by keeping the fact that they had a Caucasian father in his back pocket, as if we're too dumb to see the childish tactics that he's using. The only reason Faithful is accepting these so-called black Jews who were actually mulattoes is so that he can claim their Caucasian ancestry is the reason why they were Jews. Otherwise, he would not be acknowledging them as Jews at all. For some reason, he thinks he can talk his way out of this mess Abu has gotten him into by ranting for 4 to 5 hours on his channel and trying to distract attention away from what Abu has said, but it's not gonna work, and he's not getting away from this, and there's no way for Abu to help Faithful out with his lies. Like I've already said, the sources in question here are talking about the black Portuguese Jews themselves being black, not their descendants, and the sources in question are not talking about their blackness being the result of intermarriage between black and white people, nor are the sources talking about the black Portuguese Jews being converts. So instead of showing images of so-called black people who are the descendants of Caucasian Jewish men who intermarried with black women, Faithful needs to deal with the fact that these sources are speaking about the black Portuguese Jews being black themselves, as well as the fact that these sources did not say or even imply that these black Portuguese Jews were mulattoes or converts. Ever since Abu has admit these black Portuguese Jews were literally black, the only option he and Faithful have left now is to rely on technicalities and loopholes when it comes to how being black is perceived, and that's exactly what they are doing. They know full well that Israelites are not referring to mixed people with Caucasian ancestry when we use the word black as a classification when dealing with historical sources. That would obviously defeat the whole purpose of trying to prove these Jews were originally black in the first place. And let me put this out there while I'm at it. If Faithful's new excuse is that he did supposedly show black Jews, then why does he have a problem with Israelites saying the black Portuguese Jews were black people in the first place? Isn't that what this is all about? Black people identifying as Jews? Do you see the complete madness and double-mindedness coming from this guy? He lies and switches up his argument according to how badly he's getting debunked. As I said at the beginning, there's no need to even make this a long presentation because the dishonesty, deception, and the facts were exposed in the last video I did, and the facts are simple. The fact of the matter is that according to the sources I showed him, Abu admit these black Portuguese Jews had black skin complexions and looked nothing like the people Faithful was showing in his original attack video against Dante, and the sources Abu admit all of this about did not say these black Portuguese Jews were mulattoes or the product of interracial marriages, nor did the sources say these black Portuguese Jews were converts. And Abu did not try to argue that the sources were saying these black Portuguese Jews were mulattoes or converts when he originally admit all of this. This is going to be my last video exposing and dealing with the lies and straight-up white supremacist rhetoric that Faithful spews on a daily basis because at this point, he has been completely debunked, thanks to Abu. Abu did all of the work for us when he admit those sources were talking about the black Portuguese Jews being literal black people who did not resemble any of the people Faithful was showing in his videos. Faithful can continue to make his silly response videos for his audience of 23 viewers to try repairing his shattered ego, but anyone who is honest, Christian or Israelite, can easily see that this guy is a liar whose only goal in life is to deceive people and then lie about it when he gets caught. Faithful created his YouTube channel on May 19th, 2013, about 8.5 years ago, and the average amount of viewers he had during the duration of his last live was 23 people. If you've had a channel for that long and can only manage to attract 23 viewers, some of which are openly racist and have usernames like Rise of the Kushites, if you don't believe me, you can go back and look at his last video from December 20th if he still has the live chat available for view. But if you've had a channel for that long and can only manage to attract 23 viewers, then it's obviously more than safe to say that you aren't viewed as a source of valuable or trustworthy information by most rational people. And those anti-black racists probably feel safe and comfortable on your channel for obvious reasons. So what I'm gonna do now is, I've come up with a challenge. Since Abu and Faithful wanna play games and rely on semantics, loopholes, and technicalities, here's what I'm going to do. We are going to put up a challenge for them and ask them to provide some evidence that supports what they are claiming. Since they are both claiming Abu's admission has not contradicted or debunked Faithful's position on these black Portuguese Jews, here is the challenge. First, I'm going to lay out the groundwork. Abu admit, according to the sources he's been shown, the black Portuguese Jews were literal black people with literal black skin complexions, and he used northern Ethiopian people or Eritreans as an example. Keep in mind that those are black sub-Saharan Africans. None of the sources I showed Abu said anything about these black Portuguese Jews being converts, mulattoes, or the descendants of any interracial marriages. The only thing the sources said about them is that they were black, and Abu has agreed that this blackness was literal. So the challenge is, Abu or Faithful, present a video clip or any sort of evidence from before December 14th of this year, 2021, that shows Faithful admitting or acknowledging that the black Jews of Portugal were literal black people with literal black skin complexions like how Abu has already admitted they were. This evidence cannot include instances where Faithful has referenced black Jews who were mulattoes or converts because the sources shown to Abu were not talking about mulattoes or converts, and Abu admit they were talking about literal black people who would have had black skin complexions similar to black Africans. Abu claims he hasn't contradicted Faithful's position by admitting these black Portuguese Jews were literally black people, but he has because the sources Abu admitted were talking about the Portuguese Jews being literally black were not talking about converts or mulattoes. They were talking about the black Portuguese Jews themselves being black. Yet converts or mulattoes are the only so-called black Jews that Faithful has shown or acknowledged in his videos. If Abu or Faithful cannot produce such evidence, then that means A. Abu is in fact a liar who is trying to help Faithful cover up his own lies. B. That Faithful has not acknowledged the existence of black Portuguese Jews who were not converts, mulattoes, or the children of interracial marriages. C. That Abu has in fact contradicted and debunked Faithful to God's position on the black Portuguese Jews. And this is because, If Faithful's position is that the only black Portuguese Jews to exist were mulattoes or converts, then that is a direct contradiction to what Abu has admitted, because the sources shown to Abu were not talking about the black Portuguese Jews being mulattoes or converts, and Abu admit that they were literal black people who would have had skin tones similar to black Africans. Therefore, Abu's position is in direct contradiction with Faithful's, and Faithful has been debunked. And right here, we have the wanted poster. And it says, wanted, evidence from before December 14th of 2021 of Faithful acknowledging black Portuguese Jews who were not converts, mulattoes, and did not have Caucasian ancestry. If this evidence cannot be produced, then Abu's admission is a complete contradiction of Faithful's position, because Abu admit the black Portuguese Jews were as black as Africans, Northern Ethiopians or Eritreans specifically, and the source he saw did not say they were converts, mulattoes, or the descendants of Caucasian people. So with all of that being said, everybody, shalom.